गुड डे चिल्ड्रेन, एडवोकेट बापू साहेब भोंडे हाई स्कूल वेलकम यू ऑल इन अवर डिजिटल लर्निंग सेशन। टुडे इन अवर क्लास 4 ऑफ ईवीएस 2 वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट अवर लेसन नंबर 15, अ मेमोरेबल सेरेमनी। चिल्ड्रेन, अ मेमोरेबल सेरेमनी, लेट अस सी इन दिस लेसन व्हाट इज the memorable ceremony that is going to take place in the life of the Maratha lion Shivaji Maharaj. Why did Shivaji have himself crowned, children? Let's see. I will read for you. Pay attention. Why did Shivaji have himself crowned? Shivaji took the oath of Swaraj in the temple of Raireshwar. He had to face numerous difficulties and calamities in his efforts to win Swaraj for his people. But with the great courage and skill, Shivaji overcame them all. Swaraj had stepped out of its childhood and was growing fast. Men like Baji Prabhu, Murar Baji, Tanaji nursed it with their blood. The new kingdom was both respected and feared. My dear children, now, as we all know, that in the previous lessons we had seen that Shivaji along with Mawla friends had gone to the temple of Raireshwar and he took an oath to establish Swaraj over there at a very young age. You can see in this picture. Now his decision was firm and he moved ahead with great courage and skill. Right from his childhood stage, we know that Shivaji was very much interested in his task and somehow he wanted to accomplish his task of establishing Swaraj. He was surrounded by enemies like the Mughal Emperor of Delhi, Sultan Adil Shah of Bijapur, then the Portuguese of Goa and Siddhi of Janjira. Now all these men were strong. They had arms and ammunition, but Shivaji, with his limited source and poor mawlads, was determined to establish Swaraj. He was also helped by great men, brave men like Baji Prabhu, Murar Baji, Tanaji. These were the people who fought bravely and shed their blood for the establishment of Swaraj. Now, Shivaji had conquered a number of forts, one fort after the other. Thereby, he had created a new kingdom and it was respected and feared. Now pay attention here. With a view to having his kingdom recognized by all other princes in the land, big and small, Shivaji decided to have himself crowned. After hundreds of years, a king was born in Maharashtra who would treat all religions equally and give justice and happiness to his subjects. Shivaji decided to have himself crowned. so that everyone would come to know that Swaraj had been firmly established. He did not do it for self-glorification or personal happiness. He did it to give the newly founded Swaraj a firm footing. Now, once he had a huge kingdom, he wanted everyone to know about his kingdom. To all the people around, the princes with land, big and small. So he said, I will have myself crowned. What is the meaning of this, children? He wanted to declare himself as a king to all the people around. And for this task, he was full of planning. Now, what did he do? He called all the people because he wanted to make everyone aware of his coronation. Now, after 100 years, a king is born in Maharashtra. He was a person who would treat all religions equally, and he gave justice to all his people. All his people were very, very, very happy with him. Now, Swaraj was to be established, and it was firmly established. Now, Shivaji Maharaj did not crown himself because he wanted to show that he was a great, or because he was happy that he established so many kingdoms, not for self-glorification, children, but he wanted to have a newly founded Swaraj on a firm footing. Understood? So let's see. Pay attention here. The capital of Swaraj. Shivaji selected Raigad as the capital of his kingdom. Raigad was a strong hill fort from where it was easy to administer the kingdom and keep a watch on the enemy. Shivaji Raja inspected his troops at Chipur. He visited Pratapgarh and took the goddess Bhavani's darshan. In grateful memory, he presented to the temple a golden canopy for the goddess. The capital of Swaraj. Now, Shivaji was about to be crowned. All preparations were supposed to be taken. As a part of this preparation, Shivaji first selected a suitable capital for his kingdom, and Raigad was selected for the same. Now, why did Shivaji select Raigad? Children, Raigad was selected because it was a strong hill fort. You can see in this picture. And since it was a hill fort, it was easy to administer and you can keep watch on the enemies, who is coming, who is going, and here. So Shivaji decided Raigad as the capital of his kingdom. Yes? Now Shivaji Raja inspected his troops at Chipur. Now, children, troops means his army. And he also visited Pratapgarh. And here he went there and he took darshan of goddess Bhavani. Now we know in the previous lesson, when he went to the goddess Bhavani's temple, he already got a pot full of mohurs as a gift from the goddess Bhavani. And he was very happy, and he used this money to buy arms and ammunition and also to build the fort. Yes, the fort which was left halfway, that is the fort of Murumbadev. Now this goddess Bhavani was his favorite. So he also made a golden canopy for the goddess. Preparations for the coronation. Then Shivaji Raje ordered a golden throne to be made and had it studded with precious stones. He put a white royal umbrella over the throne. Invitations to the coronation were sent out to princes and kings, learned Brahmins, all the Sardars under his command, and other officers. Gaga Bhatt came from Varanasi to act as the chief priest at the ceremony. Gaga Bhatt originally belonged to Paithan but had settled down in Varanasi. He was a great and renowned scholar, respected in Varanasi. So children, preparations for the coronation. Now, what is coronation? Coronation is a ceremony to crown a king, to declare a person as a king. Then when he was to be declared as a king, what did he do? He ordered for a golden throne. You can see in this picture, children. He made that golden throne. And you know that the king sits on a throne. And it was not an ordinary throne. It was studded with precious stones. That means all over the throne there were precious stones like ruby and diamond and many other precious stones, and a white royal umbrella was put over the throne, and there was invitation which was prepared which had to be given for the coronation. So children, Shivaji Maharaj sent these invitations to the princes, kings, learned Brahmins and all the Sardars under his control and other officers as well. You can see in this picture. Now, Gaga Bhatt. Children, Gaga Bhatt was a very learned scholar. He was very respected in Varanasi. Actually, he belonged to the place called Paithan. You can see in this picture. But now, he had settled down there in Varanasi. So, he was also invited as the chief priest at the ceremony. Understood? Now, pay attention here. Shivaji Maharaj made detailed preparations for the coronation. Men were sent out to bring waters of the seven rivers and the sea. Nearly 50,000 people gathered at Raigad. Small tents, big tents, spacious shamianas to accommodate the guests could be seen everywhere. So children, here Shivaji Maharaj made all the detailed preparations for the coronation. Now, men were sent to bring waters from the seven rivers and the sea. Nearly 50,000 people gathered at Raigad. Now, so many people were there. Shivaji made arrangements for all of them. to stay there. So all were accommodated. What did he do? He made small tents, big tents, and spacious shamiyanas. You can see here in this picture. So children, till here we will stop. We will study about our next part of this lesson in our next video. At home, you have to read this lesson. You have to find out your new words and try to understand the meaning of that words. Okay? Kindly subscribe our channel to get more videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.